has to be raised with permission, Shri Arun Jaitley.
Sir, I am extremely grateful to you for permitting me to raise a matter of extreme importance. On the 17th of February this year, the Department of Income Tax, through the Directorate of Income Tax, and issued an order to the Government of Gujarat through its Industry Secretary. And it says that we want details from the state government of all MOUs entered by between the state and all private entrepreneurs, whether domestic or foreign, who came and attended the Vibrant Gujarat Show. Now, this is, in terms of federal polity, a huge assault on federalism in India. There is no greater abuse. There is no greater abuse. There is no greater abuse.
Please sit down. Please sit down. Please let me. The chairman has permitted to raise the issue. Please sit down. Please sit down. Please sit down. Please sit down. The chairman has permitted him to raise the issue. Please sit down. 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 Please, Rupalaji, baithiye. Aap baithiye. LOP बोल रहे हैं
सर व्हेन देयर इज
नो नो मिस्टर
सर
व्हाट इज दिस सर
प्लीज अलो हिम टू व्हाई आर यू दिस थिंग इट हैज बीन परमिटेड द गवर्नमेंट विल रिप्लाई व्हाई आर यू रिप्लाईंग
Sir,
if the government choose to reply, they will reply.
Sir, every opposition state government in this country has been complaining of discrimination of this kind. Even earlier in this house, during the debate of motion on thanks to the president's address, I had referred to what's happening in Orissa, what's happening in UP. These are not governments controlled by my party. They are controlled by parties which we don't agree with. West Bengal government is objecting. How the center is discriminating against them. Now, here is a state which is economically doing well. The state has institutionalized the system of attracting investment through this annual meet. On the eve of this annual investors meet, you first have the political party in opposition, and I say this without fear of contradiction, makes a public statement that the finance ministry must use the income tax department, it's a statement on record, in order to find out that whoever enters into an MOU with the state government will be inquired into by the income tax department. A prior preemptive statement of this effectiveness. Do you have animus against the people of Gujarat? Do you treat it as an enemy territory? Do you treat the chief minister as an enemy alien? Are the opposition chief ministers to be treated in this manner? And in every case, you, sir, have the entire facility. These are MOUs being entered into by large national and international corporations. They are bringing investment. In 1 year, 20.53 lakh crores is what is promised. It's an unprecedented amount. Instead of feeling proud, and other states must emulate that example, we wish them all the success. You let loose the income tax department against those who want to invest in the state. And this is an unprecedented move. That this gentleman, the officer concerned, writes to the state government saying, I want a list of all people who have entered into MOUs with the state. Give us all the MOUs and details of those investors so that the income tax department can hold further inquiries against them. Now, sir, this is, if the officer has done it himself, it's a dereliction of duty. It's a textbook case where Article 311(2) must be invoked. And the president must withdraw the pleasure for this gentleman to be in service. If income tax department is to be misused in this manner, and if it is done at the behest of political masters, then at least the political masters must come here and apologize to the people of this country, not only the people of Gujarat, for this stand that the central government has taken against the state.
No, no, this is